with a candle review. Today we are going to be talking about the Iced Cranberry Scone candle from Bath and Body Works. I did pick this up at a test store in Ohio, and I believe it's probably slated to come out for the Christmas holiday. I think that some people are finding them in their stores now, so I'm pretty sure that this will be coming out, hopefully nationwide to everybody. So check your stores and see if you have this one in your stores yet and upcoming for the holiday season. My dog is jumping back up and down on the, we have like a windowsill here. So the dog, I don't know what he's doing, but at least he's not barking. So there's that. So I want to welcome you if you're new to the channel. I hope you decide to stick around and subscribe down below. And I want to welcome you back if you're a returning visitor or subscriber. I'm so glad to have you as a part of this channel. So I'm going to be trying to get moving on these candle reviews again. I typically like to review them more in the fall and winter, so keep checking and make sure you're subscribed and turn on the bell notifications to see when I upload a new candle review or haul. Lots of hauls coming up, so let's get moving. All right, so this particular candle, like I said, came out for the holiday for this year. The scent notes, I wrote them down so I don't have to put this over my head. Fresh cranberry, crumbly brown sugar, and sweet vanilla. As you can see, I have been burning this candle. So it's a little bit under halfway, which I think is important because a lot of times you'll see candle reviews being done and they've lit it a couple of times or they stop at the halfway point. You know, the unfortunate thing about Bath & Body Works candles is a lot of times I get good performance right up until about halfway done. And then at that point, you know, the performance tends to go a little bit south. So yeah, I think it's important to burn the candles to at least halfway or maybe a little bit below to see if some of the typical performance issues that we see are coming out in this particular candle. I will say for this one, I did have to cotton ball it already. I think that, you know, it's just not a hot, fast burn in terms of, you know, a strong, robust flame. Definitely seemed like it was struggling to pull out and keep the flames lit, actually. So I did cotton ball this. I still have noticed it seems like, you know, there's gonna be puny flames on this particular candle, and that's just gonna be the way this one is. Let me know in the comment section down below if you pick this one up, how are your flames? Do you have puny wicks on yours? Do you get a hot, fast burn? Because on this particular one, and I do have two, I purchased two of these. They both have the same, I want to say, lot and production numbers on the bottom. So yeah, I think it's going to be about the same for both of these. But anyway, I have noticed that it does seem like it's taking a little bit of time to pull out and kind of the puny wicks. As far as sooting, there's not too much sooting on here. I am seeing a little bit of that soot in the melted wax. So I am keeping this to about 2 hour burn at a time, maybe 2.5. I kind of check it, I hover over it and just look and see if the wax pool, it looks a little bit dirty or schmutzy, as I say. Then I'm extinguishing it. I dip my wicks to put the candle flames out. I don't ever put the lids on. So yeah, that's what I have been doing on this one. And you know, cotton balling it is a great way to, if you have to cotton ball, kind of clean up some of that, you know, sootiness in the wax. I just kind of swirl the cotton ball around inside and try to pick up some of that yuckier wax that tends to float to the top. That's just how I do it. That's not saying that you have to do the same thing, but that's just how I do it to try to keep my waxes, I wanted to say pure, but as clean as possible, because that can definitely affect the scent that you're getting. How was the performance for this particular candle? When it started off, I would say it was pretty light, so I was a little disappointed. I did move it around a little bit because it is still, you know, warm-ish here in Michigan, and so my air conditioning tends to run quite a bit. We keep our house very cold, so that's why. And so I did move it around a little bit. I did find that my airflow in my kitchen is a little bit better. So that's where I had it yesterday, and I was very pleased with the performance. What I would say for this candle in that type of area or in a smaller room like this, I would say it's probably about a 6, 6.5, which is above average. So I think that is good. I am enjoying it. It's doing well in terms of that. When I had it in my kitchen, same thing, probably about a 6. I kept getting whiffs of it. Now, did it take over my whole house? No, but I was getting whiffs of it, and it was nice. So I think if you have a smaller room, maybe a smaller home without, because I have tall ceilings, I think you're gonna get a really nice performance out of this candle and will be able to smell it. I'm having a lot of problems right now with airflow and just the layout of my house on some of the Bath and Body Works candles. So I would say this is a definite hit for performance in that category, scent throw category. So speaking of scent, how do I feel about the scent of this candle? On cold, I said it did smell like a scone. It's definitely crumbly. It's not a super soft scone that you can get sometimes. There are some crumblier scones that you definitely need to dip in coffee or tea to kind of hydrate them. And that's kind of what I think a lot of people do with scones in general. But I would say this reminds me of a more crumbly type of scone. I'm not really sure why. But sometimes when you smell something, at least this happens to me a lot, when I smell something, I get a picture in my mind of what it is. To me, it's a scone with kind of like those dried cranberries, not a ton of them, but it adds a hint of sweetness, and then you get almost like an icing on top of the scone. That's what it reminds me of. Now, yesterday when I had it in my kitchen and I was getting a little bit more of the fragrance, it was definitely buttery, not popcorn, but it was like a buttery type of scone. Or even, I don't want to say too much about this, but I feel like almost a crusty type of note. It's not the same to me as the cranberry pie candle. I do have several of those still in my collection from last year. This is less cranberry. If it's the same notes that they used, like for the pie crust note, I would say that it seems like they dialed that up a little bit and the cranberry down. So if it's the same, that's what I'm getting. So if you kind of like that crusty or, bakery type of note that's buttery and almost crumbly buttery type of note, I would say that this is probably the candle for you. I really enjoy it. Now it took to get, it had to start burning its way down in order for me to get that scent to come out. It didn't come out right away on the first burn. It was slow moving in terms of the performance and the scent throw. But now that I have reached halfway and below, I am definitely getting that buttery bakery note in here, which I was looking for. So yes, I'm very pleased. I was a little bummed out at first. I will say I was like, oh, this is going to be a dud. I'm not going to be able to smell anything. And as it's burned, I definitely can tell that it's a bakery type of candle. Is it overly heavy on the cranberry? No. And honestly, if you hadn't told me it was cranberry, I wouldn't have known that, because it's not super predominant. It's a sweetness, like a fruity berry type of sweetness, but it's way in the background as compared to the bakery note. So would I purchase this candle again? I would. I will probably pick up probably one of these. I'm not going to go crazy. I do have one extra in my stash, but as long as this continues to burn well all the way to the bottom, I think I will buy at least one more, maybe two. I don't know. It just depends. It all depends on candle sales and coupons too, because that can definitely encourage me to purchase, one or two backups of something. I really do like the cranberry pie candle as well. I think this is a good, I don't want to say substitute for it, but if you liked that cranberry pie candle and you're bummed because you don't have any backups and it doesn't look like that at least is on the list now, never say never, but at least it's not on the list now to return for the holidays, and you're looking for an alternative to that candle, maybe pick this one up and give it a try. If you are a bakery lover, I also think this is a good one to try. I am enjoying it, and I look forward to your comments once you burn them as well, and let me know what you think. So thank you so much for watching my review of the Iced Cranberry Scone candle from Bath & Body Works. I hope you've decided to stick around and subscribe. Give me a like for this video, and I will see you next time. Bye, everybody!